In today's video, I am going to tell you the difference between 21, 22, 18 and 24 karat gold. Why do you need to see this video? It's important for you to learn because sooner or later, all of you will purchase gold at some point of time. But 99% of times it happens that people don't know exactly what is the difference between these karats of gold. And why is there a price difference? This topic is actually very intense and technical. I have tried to make it as simple as possible. So let's get started.
First of all, we need to understand what is 24 karat of gold. 24 karat of gold is the purest form of refined gold. It is divided into 24 parts and all the parts are gold. The purity of 24 karat gold is 99.9%, which is written as 999.9. It is the most common form of storing gold. Although pure gold is most preferred, it is not very favorable to make jewelry. Reason being, gold is a very soft and a malleable metal. It cannot hold the shape for a very long time. And even if you make jewelry out of pure 24 karat gold, it has to be really strong and thick. You cannot have a lot of designing done to it. To solve this problem, jewelers had to add alloys to gold. Now let's see what's an alloy. Alloys are other metals added to gold to improve its functionality, workability, and make it strong enough to hold the designs. In case of gold, some very popular alloys are copper, silver, palladium, platinum, etc. However, the most commonly used alloys are copper and silver. Pure gold is melted with these alloys in different proportions to get different carats of gold. It's heated at a very high temperature and melted as a liquid. When 22 parts of gold and 2 parts of alloy are melted together, it produces a very bright yellow color. This is 22 carat of gold. Similarly, out of the 24 carat of gold, if 21 parts are gold and 3 parts are alloy, it will be 21 carat gold. And yes, you have guessed it right. In 18 carat gold, 18 parts are gold and 6 parts are alloys. In a nutshell, let's view all of it together. 75% gold, 25% alloy is 18 carat, also stamped as 750 purity. 87.5% gold and 12.5% alloy is 21 carat gold, also stamped as 875 purity. 91.6% gold and 8.4% alloy is 22 karat gold, also stamped as 916 purity, and 99.9% gold, 0.1% dirt or dust is 24 karat gold, also stamped as 999.9. Now let's see what should be your choice of metal. In 22 karat gold, the brightness of gold is very high, but it is best suited for plain jewelry. Since the percent of gold is very high, it is very soft and it may not hold the prongs or the fittings of gemstones or diamond in it. 21 carat of gold is most popular in the Middle East. It is bright and has a very nice color. It can also hold gemstones, especially the big ones, but it is not recommended for diamonds. You can have plenty of beautiful designs done in 21 karat gold. Basically, it has a way out between 22 and 18 karat gold. It is nice and bright, can hold stones, but still very malleable. 18 karat is the most sought after gold globally. The color is suitable to most skin types and tones. It is subtle and has a very nice chic finishing to it. You can have plenty of sophisticated designs done in 18 karat gold. Since there are 6 parts of alloy, it is really strong and can hold the design and the diamonds together very well. And of course, as you all know, 24 karat gold bars, 5 grams, 10 grams, 15 grams are best for gifts and storing gold as security. These bars can also be exchanged or given to the jeweler and can be used to make jewelry in different carats of gold. This video would be incomplete if I did not mention rose gold and white gold. So what are these? Let's see. Rose gold is also 18 karat gold. It has 75% of gold and 25% of alloy. The rich pink color in rose gold usually comes with more of copper in its alloy. The copper has nice pink color to it, and that's why it transforms the color of the overall jewelry to a soft rose pinkish color. Similarly, white gold is also 18 karat gold with 25% of white metal alloys and 75% of gold. It has its nice rich white color due to the use of white metals in its alloy. In the West, 14 karat and 9 karat of gold is also very famous. You have understood by now that in 14 karat, it only means out of 24, 14 parts are gold, and in 9 karat, out of 24, 9 parts are gold. One of the most common myths with trading gold is that people believe if I have 18 karat of gold, I will get less money in return, and if I have 24 or 22 karat of gold, I will get more money when I exchange gold. Friends, try to understand that when you buy gold, you pay lesser for 18 karat because the rate of 18 karat gold will be less in compared to 21 and 22 karat gold. Similarly, when you sell, you will get the price of gold on that day. It is not that you are getting more or less depending on the carat of gold. You have what price you have purchased during sale, you will recover the same price. The prices of gold vary depending on their caratage. However, the global price of gold is always announced in 24 carat.
I hope this information was helpful for you. Please do share it with your friends and family so that they can benefit too. Check out NafisaDesigns.com and check out the custom jewelry section. Here I have done plenty of orders from design to reality in 18, 21, 22 karat gold. You will see a lot of examples. You will see examples in white gold and rose gold as well. If you need to make anything customized, please do contact me. I'll be very glad to help you. And thank you so much once again for watching. Keep connected.